Hello friends, this module will cover the effective Googling part of the MOOC. As we all know that Google is no more a search engine, it is a verb now, because you also say that we should Google this, we should Google that. So in that case, we are using it as a verb, not as a search engine. So this whole presentation will cover the art of effective Googling on the internet. So in this module, you will get a first-hand introduction about the effective Googling on the internet. And this module considers Google as a verb, as I have already told you. It is not a search engine anymore. And you know, all the big search engines, they allow uses of some special commands for effective searching, like Boolean operators, capital and capital or and the double quotes. So these are now standardized commands which are applicable across all the websites and all the softwares. So let's see what we'll be covering in this module. So we'll be basically covering three things. The first is effective Googling, and second one is meta searching, and third one is Google Power Searching command. So let's start with the effective Googling part of it. Effective Googling basically means it is the concept of information right sizing. That is, we should limit the results on the Google website, which results in the overburden of the information, and the results should be filtered. So this is the effective Googling part of it. When it comes to meta searching, you should search in the meta search engines, and these search engines retrieve the results simultaneously from various search engines and filter the duplicate content. So it is always advisable to use a meta search engine rather than a particular search engine, because meta search engine searches many search engines for you and remove the duplicate part of it rather than one search engine. And while coming to the third portion, that is Google Power Searching, in this you will shift from the digital pessimist to digital optimist by developing an insight into the reduced and qualitative information. For example, most of us use Google in a pessimist way rather than a optimist way. We just enter the information in the Google and wait for so many millions of results which are not comprehensible to us. So that is the pessimist part of it. So if we know the Google Power Searching commands, then we'll have information in a few hundred. So that is the optimist part of it. In short, you will be an expert handler of Google Power Searching in this module. So let's start with the meta search engines. So a definition of the meta search engine is that it is a search tool that uses another search engine's data to produce its own results from the internet. And Dogpile and Yippee, these are the very good meta search engines, because Dogpile searches Google, Yahoo, Ask, and Live. Live is the name of the search engine. Whereas Yippee searches Ask.com, Gigablast, and Yahoo News. So these are fairly good meta search engines, and they don't store your privacy details, and they are fairly easy in operation also. Let's come to meta literacy. This is a concept related with the new age researchers. Actually, it is a unified construct that supports the acquisition, production, and sharing of knowledge in collaborative online communities. So see, I have bold the keywords here, like acquisition. You acquire the information, you produce it, and you share it in a collaborative online community. So unless a researcher have all these qualities, then so he or she will not be a good meta literate person. And meta literacy is very much required in the today's pedagogical atmosphere. Meta literacy promotes critical thinking and collaboration in a digital age. It leads to a comprehensive framework to effectively participate in the social media and online communities. Now here, critical thinking, collaboration, and participate words are very, very important, which forms the hallmark of a good researcher. If you come to data retrieval, the data retrieval is defined as obtaining the data from the website by using the commands and techniques. Data, information, and knowledge. See, we all the researchers are very used to use these three terms in a very irrational and random way, but these are entirely different terms. Data is unstructured, information is structured and right-sized, whereas knowledge it is contextual. So in another ways, information is structured also, it is right sized, and knowledge is structured, right sized, and contextual also. So a good meta researcher, meta literate researcher should have the power of distinguishing between these three terms. Next is Google custom search engine. So this is slightly off the mark because all of us, they use any kind of search engine in some way, but many of us don't know that we can create our own Google customized search engine. This is the link, google.com / and CSE. If you go to that, so it will ask you that how many websites do you want to search. In the short way, it gives you the power of limiting your searches to the a few number of websites defined by you. Like it searches multiple websites, it will filter the duplicate links, it will give you a public URL of your search engine. It's not that you will not be able to share it with others. Yeah, you can create your own Google customized search engine of the websites of your own choice, and you can allow the public to search inside that. So I have created one for you now. It is available at tinyurl.com/hindi search engine. So in this I have selected 10 Hindi newspapers websites, and if you go to the URL link of this, so you will be able to search inside those Hindi websites. I'll show it in the practical part also. So let's have a few facts about the Google. So we are not promoting Google here, as I've already told you that for us Google is a verb now. So as you can see on the screen, that the American Dialect Society chose the word Google as the most powerful word of 2002. It was added to the Oxford Dictionary on June 15, 2006, and to the Merriam-Webster Collegiate Dictionary in 2006. And the third one is that Google is the most widely used search engine on the internet, with a daily search queries of 2.5 million searches per second, which comes to 100 billion searches per month and nearly 2 trillion nearly. So it is a fairly good amount of search volume. So let's come to the rational part of it, why we should use Google for the effective search. The first one is that there is a growing dissatisfaction with the traditional traditional search, because if we observe our own information behavior, then we'll see that our search behavior, online information searching behavior, is the same for the last 5 to 6 years. So that's an area of concern. Yeah. The second one is that we should be efficient workers. It's not that whatever is given to us by the Google, the millions of results, and they are acceptable to us. No, so that's not an information kind of thing. So efficient way of working is required. The third one, which is fairly unknown to everybody, is that Google leads to the production of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, and we should be very careful about that. So reduced carbon footprints is another reason that we should use the Google for effective search. And the last but one is responsible use of technology. Yes, we have all limited times and limited energy. We should invest all of these things in the responsible use of the technology. The last one is the information overload. As you all know that the society is passing through a information overload phase. We have much more information than we can process. So all these 5 points, they offer a fairly good justification or the rationale of using the Google Power Search for the effective search. Now we come to the power searching commands. This is a real practical session, and we'll make it in the hands-on.
So let us see a real-time demonstration of the Google Power Searching commands. So there are around 12 commands, and they have been extensively discussed in the theory part, but here we would be executing these commands one by one. So let's start with a define command. If you want to search the meaning of any word or any concept, then just write define and enter that concept or the word. So I want to see the meaning of halo effect, so I'll enter, and the very first result would be there about the definition of this concept. For more detailed information on Halo Effect, you can refer to the underlying results. So this is very useful for the researchers, because many new terms are coming to the public domain day by day. So it is very important for us to know about those new terms. Then is double quote. So if you want to search something, for example, careers in research analytics, then you see there are millions of results, and you can't even count them. But do you think that all these results are relevant? I think no, because if you enter the query as such in the Google, then it will search all the documents which are having the words career, research and analytics separately. So it will combine all the documents which are having the words career and documents which are having the word research and those having the analytics. So artificially the results are jacked up. So it is better to use the double quotes here and then enter, and then see the results are reduced. There are only 14 results here. These results, they have the words careers in research analytics together, and they are highlighted also here. So it is advisable to enter the words with the double quotes if it is more than one word. For even one word, you can use the double quotes. For examples, if you enter the word empower and put it in the double quotes and then search, then it will show many results. But the point which I want to highlight here is that if you put double quote on any word, then it will not search the derivatives of those words. Like, it will not search the word empowerment, empowering, etc. Like, you can see that it is searching only empower. So it is a pure search for that word. If you want to have all the derivatives of the word, then don't use the double quotes. Then it will search empowerment, empowering, empowered, etc. Then is AND OR. So if you want to search the internet for the documents which have the word empower and technology and women and web, then it will bring out those documents which are having these words. Internet, women, empowerment, etc. So it is very good command to limit the the results to a certain extent. And if you enter OR, then it will increase the result, because you are giving the option here. So web or internet or technology. Sorry, it has been already used, or computer. So it will increase the result, as you can see here, because we have given the option. So this command, which is known as the Boolean operator, AND, OR, these are Boolean operators. They have to be used always in the caps, not in the small letters, because if you use them in the small letters, then Google will treat this as a word, not as a command. Next is file type. So if I enter the command like file type colon PDF, and if I write something here like research methodology, then it will give us the result only in the PDF formats. As you can see here, there are PDF formats files only. You can change this to PPT, and all the PPT files would come, or you can change this to DOCX, Excel, or whatever the format you want in, and results will also change. So this is file type. This is very important for the researchers, because all the major publications, they are in the PDF formats, and PDF documents are the serious documents. And if you want to search inside a particular website, then we should use the command site colon name of the website. I am entering hindustantimes.com, and then I'll click enter. This command will limit the search only up to within the limit of this the website which we have entered here, like hindustantimes.com. It will not go outside this website, and it will search the these two words in sequence, research methodology. So it is telling me that there are around 51 results of it. This website cannot, it can be changed, and the name of the publication's website can be put here, and accordingly you can enter your research query here and search for the research papers inside that research publication website. So that is a very good command. And if you want to limit this to a certain time frame, then click tool here and then anytime. In anytime you can select any one of these, like past 1 year, past month, past week, or you can search between two custom dates also. The next is domain name searching. Domain name, it is quite similar to the site command. The only difference is that when you write site colon, then again you have to enter .com. So you can replace this .com with .au, .us, .edu, .in. So your research query would be limited only to that particular domain. Like if I search here, so it will only search the .com domain area. I replace it with .in, that is India, and press enter. Then it is telling me that there are around 321,000 results from the .in domain, which have the words research methodology together. And if I combine the command with the file type PDF, then I will get more relevant results, 176,000. And most of them are from India and from UGC, Shodhganga, in FlipNet, etc. So this way you can rationalize your results yourself. And the time frame command has been discussed. We come to entitled command. So entitled title command is I want to find some documents which are having a particular word in the title of the document. So I would say that file type is PDF and these are two words, and in title I want the word research and enter. Now it is telling me there are 473,000 documents which are having the documents which are having the research word in their title along with these combinations. So if you want to add one more word in the title, then you can type command search and method. This time the result will fall because you have added one more condition here. So you can open any one of these links and find that these two words would be there in the title of the document. In text command, so keeping all these commands intact, if I want to further refine my research query and say that I want the documents in the PDF format, I want these two words in the text and in the title research and method, and I specify a few words which should be there in the text, not in the title, then I can enter them web and technology. Now this is fairly complex command, so results will drastically fall this time, 48,600, because I have added many conditions here that in the text we should have these words true. So it is showing me the documents which are having these conditions. In URL command, so I will delete this, and these two commands are in get. Now in URL I enter the word technology, then it means that I want this word technology in the URL, that is the link of the document. If I enter, then there are 8,730 results. As you can see that the word technology is there along with research methodology. So this is the word technology, this is technology, this is the URL, that means the address of the website. Who is command? Who is command is very important for finding the credentials of the website. Sometimes we receive messages from many different websites and we are not able to know which website is authentic. So we would enter the who is in the Google and press enter. So it will bring out a few websites, you click any one of it. Whois.com, and if I want to search my website here, umeshare.in, who is that? It will tell me my name of website, the registrar's name, it was registered on this date, it is expiring on this date, updated on this date, and my organization GJU, state Haryana, and my phone numbers, every kind of data it is there. So by looking at this information, you can be fairly sure of the credentials of the website and whether you want to believe it or not. And the last command is minus command. Minus command is for deleting a particular word from the search. For example, I enter PPT and then research methodology in the double quotes. Here I don't want the results which are having the word, for example, web. Now see, it is telling me 4050 results. I haven't clicked enter here, so I am going to delete the documents which are having the word web from this result. If I press enter, then okay, I have slightly changed the query. Now you want to search PPT for research methodology and internet, but I want to remove the documents which are having the word web. So it is telling me that there are 450 results. If I want to further cut down the results by deleting more words, then I can enter them here and then press enter, and results will further reduce. Now this time 320 results are there. So this way you can use the Google Power Searching commands to retrieve the information as per your own research requirements and the objectives. So you don't have to worry about the information overload and the data upload on the internet will not be able to bother you. Just remember these commands and use. Thank you so much.
Okay, finally, just to wrap up this presentation, we should be having some caution with the search commands, and the cautions are that you can try any number of combination of these commands. Google tells you only the basic commands and it is up to you to use the different commands in different combinations. Any kind of combination is okay. So don't limit yourself to just one or two commands, and don't worry about the exact sequence which I just showed you. Just you are free to use any sequence of the commands. And second is that these Boolean operators like AND, OR, these are standardized commands. These are Boolean operators. These are not the words, and they should be used in the capital letters. If you use them in small letters, Google will understand it in a words way, which will give the wrong results. The third one is that these same set of commands can be used in the different Google products like scholar.google.com, YouTube, and Google News. So a researcher should have a good wingspan. He or she should have so many websites to search on. So as far as the Google product is concerned, these commands will be applicable across the board on these platforms, including YouTube. The last one is that the increased complexity in the commands beyond a certain limit is most likely to produce a wrong result, as we know we may not be able to comprehend the full design of the command, because if we go on entering the different queries like women and crime or this, that, so beyond a certain limit it is beyond our own comprehension what we really want to get this command from. So results would be maybe erroneous, because Google is a tested platform, so it will not err, it will not make the mistake in delivering the results, but that should be understandable also. And finally, if you arrive at a certain results, for example 100 or 200, then you should always open at least 4 or 5 results and verify whether these are the right results for you or not. Thank you so much.